Hey guys, so we're going to be installing this Alpine overhead into a 2010 Ford Expedition. Before we get started, we want to scope out the area. Now this is going to be a little bit of a trickier install because we have to contend with the sunroof and there's also vents in the roof as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to scope out, we're going to look as much as we can inside before we decide how we're going to mount this thing. Now upon first inspecting the headliner, we also came across that there are side curtain airbags, so now we have to work around this as well.
Alright, so we've inspected behind here. There actually is a plate going all across here because these trucks do come with an aftermarket piece, so I'm assuming that's how they mount it. So we've inspected it, we've gone ahead and marked it off with masking tape to give us a general guideline we're going to make our cut. The nice thing is this isn't the exact science. You don't have to make a perfect cut in a specific place because you can adjust the unit as long as the unit covers up the hole, because once you make your cut, probably a truck like this is probably about at least $3,000 to replace this headliner. Now, before I make the cut, I'm actually going to heat it up with a torch. That way the blade cuts through the material a lot easier, and it's going to cauterize the material and give us a cleaner cut afterwards. Also on your alpha blade, break off a new piece so then you're starting with a fresh tip so it's nice and sharp. So on that horizontal tape you can see that I put down before, that's my guideline. I'm going to cut around that. That way I'm just not making a cut anywhere. I want to make this as central as possible to make it a nicer install. And once you're done making your cuts, you can go ahead and pull out the piece. And now we have access to our brace and everything in here. All right, so I got Logan on the other side with the drill, and we have to run new wire from the head unit down to the truck. So we're gonna run door pin, constant, accessory, and ground. And we're gonna do this nicer, so we're gonna wrap it all up and tape it up. And with Logan's help, we're gonna go ahead and tape this thing. Now that does go a lot smoother if I wasn't holding the camera at the same time and I had my other hand to guide the wire. Alright, so we've gone ahead and ran our wiring through the headliner, and we're just going to go ahead and solder these all up. Now we haven't made any connections to the vehicle, so all these lines are dead, so it's okay if the wires touch one another, so it's not going to short anything out. So we'll go ahead and we'll solder up all these wires. And to clean up our install and to insulate the wires properly, we're going to go ahead and use the shrink tube. You just find using shrink tube and solder is just a much more reliable connection and a lot cleaner. And to clean it all up, just go ahead and zap strap it. Yes, it's a busy shop. Alright, so let's recap what we've done so far. Now you saw the metal brace that was there before. Now we've actually put in a piece of wood to space it down because one, it's a used gear, and of course we don't have all the parts. I don't even have the metal mounting plate anymore, so we have to use this. And it was up too far, so we had to come down with the wood so it actually is going to butt up against it nicely and suck in the screen tight against the headliner. Now you can see that we have three RCAs. These two red ones over here are for this spot over here. We'll let the customer plug it in so then they can play audio through the speakers if they choose to. And this white one here is a video output so we can drive auxiliary screens.
We've also gone ahead and put a little bit of tape on the RCA so when it's tucked up in there, they don't have any chance of getting loose on us, because I really don't want to drop this down again just to plug RCAs back in. You saw me solder and shrink wrap this stuff and zap strap it up nicely. So we're ready to put the screen up.
Okay, so far so good. As you can see with the plate on the other side of the headliner, as we're mounting it, it starts to suck up the unit into the headliner, giving you a much nicer clean install. We already have a screw here and a screw here installed. We're going to show you how we're mounting this thing. Now, because we don't want to just screw right through the carpet right away, because there's a chance that the threads might catch and just really tear apart the headliner on the other side, we're actually taking a pick and heating it up and making a hole in the headliner before we put the screw in. Get the tip nice and hot, pump it through the headliner. And now we're ready to put the screws in. As you watch here, it's going to suck it right up against the headliner. See, the gap's all gone. One more to go. Go slow with your screw so you don't burn up the threads, don't burn up the wood. You want it to catch. And of course, do a final test with the sunroof visor. That's the lowest point. Nothing's catching. We're looking good.
Alright, so I'm just in the middle of wiring up this sucker. So we need constant, accessory, and ground. Ground's pretty straightforward, you go straight to metal. We're using our trusty power probe to test everything. Constant, we're hitting the initial wiring for this, and we're adding our own fuses. So here we can see that's constant. And now I'm going to show you, now we have accessory hooked up, I'm going to show you what that looks like. So first you're going to see ground. And then when we turn the ignition on, it's going to go to 12 volts power. And then during the crank cycle, it's going to go back to ground. And then back to power again once the vehicle's running. Now, the reason why accessory does that is because during the crank sequence, we don't need those devices to be powered up. That way, if you notice your radio shuts off when you turn on your ignition, that's why. So all the power goes to the start, off to your starter and your ignition components. We also want to use the overhead's dome light, so we have to go ahead and tap the dome light circuit. It's here in the passenger kick on this truck. You can see it's right here. It's already soldered on. We're just going to go ahead and tape it up. Okay, so we're all done. You can see that the dome lights work properly. And we're going to turn on in a second. Unfortunately, I can't play a DVD for you due to copyright reasons, but I'm going to show you the unit working right now. So it turns on the accessory or the ignition position, of course. And that's how you do an overhead.